Hey SuperZMaplers, I'm SuperCaptain. In this video, we are going to go through the newest MapleStory event called the Goo Island Getaway event. This event is pretty good, also pretty complicated, so I will break stuff down for you so you could understand what the event is about, how to participate, how to get rewards from it, how to get the most out of this event. I will tell you some basic stuff about the event, and I will split all of the different parts of the whole event to multiple videos, that it's pretty hard to tell it all in one go. Basically, to enter the Goo Island, you need to find the Gachapon. The Gachapon is in Henesis, Nameless Town, and Lifer. Only in those towns. You will get a quest there to enter the island, and eventually you will find yourself as a Goo in the Goo Island. This event has multiple things. All of those islands you see here give different things. So this island is the Fruitapalooza. There's the Goo Ruins Exploration Island called Die Hunt. There's the Goo Battle Island, and there's the Tranquility Falls. Basically, I will tell you about two of the five mini events in this event. Other information I have to mention is that you can only enter this event once you reach level 101 and to Tranquility Falls in level 105. Now, let's start with the Goo Gachapon. You can get a lot of rewards from this event: Medal of Honor, Node Stones, EXP coupons, you can get a nice chair, you can get all of those. To use the Gachapon, you need the Gachapon coins. You can get the Goo coins from multiple places. You can either grind mobs and get the drops, or you can complete daily missions and it's guaranteed to get you at least one coin every day. And that's the first mini event. The second one is the Tranquility Falls. Now, Tranquility Falls is a pretty unique concept Nexon has made, and it actually does something pretty amazing. You can rest in one of the seven spots that there are to get either traits or EXP. You can rest in the white one to get EXP. You need to get to level 105 plus for that. You can get empathy in the green one, you can get diligence in the yellow one, you can get charm in the pink one, in the purple one you can get insight, the blue one gives willpower, and the red one gives ambition. Now, all of those will act the same, just give you different stuff. So let's say I rest in the diligence pool for a second, I will slowly get more diligence. A couple of diligence points until the 500 cap, just as normal traits. Let's just see my traits for a second. I can get more diligence. And there we go. I just leveled up my diligence to level 6. And that's basically how it works. Now, the EXP is kinda trash, but you can also get pretty cool stuff from it. There we go. I just got 27k EXP, and every couple of seconds I will get more. It's pretty bad for level 200 characters and above, just like me. Now, after you sit a certain time in the Tranquility Falls, you can actually get big bonus. So like, you can get from the EXP one, you can get after 3 hours 3 EXP coupons, and after 8 hours more EXP coupons, and even more and more and more. Also, you can only get the rewards the day after. So if you sit for 8 hours in the EXP one today, you will get the EXP coupons tomorrow. And it's actually a pretty nice way to get free EXP coupons, which is very nice. And yeah, that's about it for Tranquility Falls and also this video. Let me know if you enjoyed the video. Don't forget to subscribe, like, share it if you find it useful. And I will see you in the next one, SuperZMaplers. Bye bye.